On today's episode, blue hydrogen for CO2-free fuel-agnostic diesels. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Decarbonization of transportation is a key part of the fight against global warming, with electric vehicles widely regarded as the logical next step for cars and trucks. EVs, however, are not the only way to achieve zero carbon emissions, and Columbus, Indiana-based engine maker Cummins has introduced a new engine that the firm calls fuel agnostic, capable of operating on either diesel fuel, natural gas, or hydrogen. Natural gas has a long history in internal combustion engines and is a proven technology in diesel cycle power plants. Although not carbon neutral, natural gas is widely recognized as an efficient intermediate fuel with a lower carbon footprint than diesel. But the significance of the new Cummins engine series is that a zero CO2 hydrogen fueled version shares the same engine architecture below the head gasket as the diesel and natural gas variants. Cummins X series, L series, and B series engines will be offered with hydrogen fueling. With a common engine block architecture, engineers designing equipment for diesel or natural gas power can specify a hydrogen power plant with minimal changes in engine mounting, accessory drives, or cooling systems. Hydrogen as a fuel for internal combustion engines has not been extensively explored, compared to hydrogen fuel cells generating electricity, a technology first widely applied in spacecraft. According to Cummins, burning hydrogen gas in an engine has another key advantage beyond packaging commonality with diesels. Hydrogen internal combustion engines tolerate hydrogen gas with higher levels of impurities than fuel cells require. Locations where hydrogen gas supply can be made locally with existing technology like methane steam reforming, combined with the ability to use industrial grade gas, can significantly lower operating costs. But could that hydrogen be made both carbon neutral and cost effective? Well, fossil fuel derived hydrogen carries a CO2 cost compared to electrolyzer hydrogen, but is significantly cheaper. One possibility is carbon capture at the point of production, a strategy planned by India's Reliance Industries at the firm's Jamnagar oil refinery in Gujarat, India. There, blue hydrogen will be produced from syngas, which is already made at the refinery's petroleum coke gasifier complex in significant volumes, up to 1 million tons annually. Keeping costs competitive, currently estimated at just under $1.50 a kilogram, depends on the carbon capture scheme. The gasifier system produces highly concentrated CO2 byproduct, which can be captured at 15 million tons per year at the refinery at 30% of the cost of atmospheric carbon capture technology. Diesel engines use fossil fuels in the form of kerosene and natural gas, but in the future they might use fossil fuel-derived hydrogen without the CO2 impact, but with similar performance. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.